Hey guys, hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to take on the hairy cell leukemia. So hairy cell leukemia is actually a type of chronic leukemia, which means that it arises from the neoplastic proliferation of the mature lymphoid cells. So if you haven't watched my video on the basics of chronic leukemias, myeloproliferative disorders, I would recommend you to watch those videos first, because I have discussed in huge detail about the chronic leukemias and the myeloproliferative disorder, and it will be quite easy for you to understand the hairy cell leukemia then. So let's start the hairy cell leukemia. See guys, in this condition, what happens over there is that within the bone marrow, there occurs the neoplastic proliferation of the B cells. So as a result of this, let's say this is a B cell, there will occur the neoplastic proliferation of the B cells, and they will gradually fill the whole bone marrow. There is something special about these cells, that is, these cells contain fine hair-like cytoplasmic processes, and that's why these cells are called as the hairy B cells. And that is why this leukemia is called as hairy B cell leukemia. Now, these hairy cells within the bone marrow, they will also be released into the peripheral circulation. So as we see in the peripheral blood film, there will be normal lymphocytes, and just in between the normal lymphocytes, there will be hairy cells, which would also be present in the peripheral blood smear. Also, these proliferated B cells, they will release certain cytokines, and these cytokines, they will cause the bone marrow fibrosis. So in the hairy cell leukemia, one of the important findings is that there is bone marrow fibrosis, which is due to the release of cytokines from the B cells. Also, these cells will infiltrate the spleen, and this will lead to splenomegaly, which is the enlargement of the spleen. So the basic pathophysiology of hairy cell leukemia or hairy B cell leukemia is the bone marrow fibrosis and splenomegaly. So if we talk about the clinical features, first of all, there is pancytopenia. This pancytopenia is basically due to the bone marrow fibrosis, and as a result of bone marrow fibrosis, the bone is not able to make up the cells of the hematopoietic system of all the lineages, and that's why there is pancytopenia. The second feature is splenomegaly, which I already told you is because of the infiltration of the spleen by these lymphocytes. And third feature is that there is bone marrow fibrosis, which is due to the release of cytokines. So these are the basic clinical features of the hairy cell leukemia. Now let's talk about how do we diagnose the hairy cell leukemias. So if we talk about the diagnosis of hairy cell leukemia, there are mainly two things which can make the diagnosis of hairy cell leukemia easier. Number one, we have the peripheral blood smear. So in the peripheral blood smear, as I already told you, we'll see special lymphocytes which are called as the hairy cells. And these hairy cells, they contain special hair-like cytoplasmic processes, and that's why they are called as hair cell. Now, apart from that, we have immunophenotyping. Now, via this immunophenotyping, we can detect certain markers which are present on the B cells, and if these markers are present, then we can say that it is a hairy cell leukemia. So the markers which are specific for the hairy cell leukemia are the same markers which are specific for the B lymphocytes, and these are CD20, CD19 and CD10. Now, apart from peripheral blood smear and immunophenotyping, there is another diagnostic criteria, and it is basically the detection of an enzyme which is called as tartrate resistant acid phosphatase. So if this enzyme is stainable or this enzyme is detectable, then we can be sure that it is a case of hairy cell leukemia. So this is a short video on hairy cell leukemia, its clinical features, pathophysiology and the diagnosis. I hope you like this video. For more videos like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.